The first step to finding trending sounds and trending posts within your niche on Instagram is you need to make sure that you have two things. First, a list of 10 to 12 of the biggest hashtags for your niche and are the most representative of what you should actually be posting about in your niche. Secondly, you need to have a list of 5 of the biggest creators within your niche and then 5 of the biggest creators that are up and coming. Now, when it comes to the list of creators that are the biggest, do not pick people that are famous. Do not pick people that are not posting reels. Do not pick people that aren't actively posting on Instagram right now, because you guys would be very surprised to believe that a lot of those creators that grew in Instagram 1.0, they faked a lot of followers, they faked a lot of engagement, and they're not people that you should be modeling your content after, because they're not people that got real organic growth on Instagram. And if you're watching this video, that should be what you're going for. Once you have those lists, you need to make sure that you do a couple things. First, you need to follow every single one of those hashtags. Secondly, you need to go under those hashtags, follow the creators that are making the best content under those hashtags, the ones with the most views. Make sure you watch those videos all the way through. Make sure you like those videos and make sure that you comment on those videos. Now, you need to do the same exact thing when it comes to the competitor list that you just created. And now what this is going to do is going to completely change the Instagram algorithm for you. It's going to change your explore feed. It's going to change your actual feed, and it's going to change your reels feed. And ultimately, it's going to trick Instagram into showing you exactly what is trending in your niche. And now I'm going to share with you how you can use this to your advantage. Because ultimately, now that you have those videos, what you do with those videos is going to determine whether or not you go viral on Instagram and whether or not you grow right now on Instagram, where there is a ton of organic reach. And trust me, since you're watching this video, I probably know how you feel. You probably missed out on Instagram 1.0, or you saw a ton of success and then you saw the huge drop off in organic reach, and now you're seeing it come back and you want to take advantage of it. Either way, I got you covered. But before I dive into that, if you want to grow faster on Instagram, TikTok, or YouTube in 2022, please make sure you smash that subscribe button. I release a YouTube video every single day, and I answer every single DM that I get on Instagram and every single comment that I get below on my YouTube channel. So please hit me up if you have questions about anything. And I created a free Instagram growth course that you can get at the link in the pinned comment below. So please make sure you get into it. It has a ton of information about the best time you should post, what hashtags to use, and even how the Instagram algorithm works. Now that you have these posts, you need to do a couple things. First, you need to study the length of how long these posts were. Please do not make the mistake of looking at these creators, seeing that they're posting IGTV, posting videos, or posting photos, and then thinking that you need to do that. You need to hone in on their real strategy. They're putting all that effort into all that other garbage, which does not have organic reach yet on Instagram, and they're not putting 100% effort into reels. That's where you're gonna beat these people. That's where you're gonna beat your competition, by focusing on what actually matters. And you need to make sure that you're paying attention to the length of their posts and making sure that your posts are of a similar length. In addition to that, you need to pay attention to the hooks they're using. You need to watch a video, not from the perspective of, oh, I'm going to consume this as a viewer, but that you're studying the actual video. What hook did they use? What camera angle did they use? Why did they do that? What kind of description did they use? What hashtags did they use? What sound did they use? All of these things, the Instagram Reels algorithm takes into consideration, and it's going to determine whether or not you get views on your Instagram Reels. And there's a ton of stuff that you can learn from your competitors. Because remember, if you're going to be competing against these people, one, you have to make better content from them. Two, let them do a lot of the learning for you. For example, if you're an anime creator and you see somebody do certain videos about a certain anime and you see that it works, and then you see them do about another anime and it doesn't work, or maybe you see a sound that they use in their videos, or a hook that they use in their videos, or a format that they use, use that all as learnings and then just implement the things that are working for them. If you're doing this across the top hashtags, the top creators, and the top up and coming creators, you are not only going to see more growth than those people, but you're going to stay on top of the trends before they even become trends. In addition to that, you need to make sure that when you find a sound on one of these videos, you click into the sound, see how many other reels have been made. I would not use a sound, I wouldn't consider it trending, unless at least 10,000 reels were also made to that sound. And you need to make sure that the other videos that are showing up there that are getting a lot of views are things that are in your niche. For example, I've done this so many times on just the reels feed. I'll click on something, it'll be a car video. I'll click on the sound, all of the videos made, there might be 16,000 videos made to it, they're all other car videos. You guys need to make sure that that sound is specifically trending for what you're actually posting about. You do not want to focus on the broad trends on Instagram reels. Instead, you want to focus on the very niche specific ones, because ultimately that's what's going to get you a lot more followers, because you need to be focused on your actual niche on Instagram. On TikTok, you might want to focus more broadly, but on Instagram, you want to be very specific to your niche, because there are so many creators already on Instagram. So many of these niches are already fully developed, and Instagram and Facebook have so much information about whether or not you're actually interested in something. So if you're showing Instagram all the things that they want to see, and they already know that this person has interacted with fitness ads or car ads or whatever you're posting about, they've interacted with ads about that, they've interacted with other reels about that, then when you use that sound and create that video, that's gonna push that video on them, and you're gonna get way more views than you ever would have. Now, the reason that so many of you guys think that trending sounds aren't working for you is because you're just going to the sounds that Instagram is actually pushing on you guys and saying, hey, you should use these sounds in your video. They're the for you sounds that show up when you just click on the sounds on Instagram Reels. And this is what is hurting your account because you didn't vet them. Like I just mentioned, you need to make sure that these aren't just based on something that Instagram wants you to use or something that Instagram has a deal with where they're actually trying to push this person's music. You need to make sure that that sound is actually trending for the content that you're going to be creating. Otherwise, it is not going to work. It is not going to help you. You are not going to get more views and it might actually end up hurting your account. Another thing that you need to take into consideration is that if you didn't do all the things that I mentioned earlier in this video, those sounds that they're going to be forcing on you, they're not going to be for your niche. They're going to be for whatever your Instagram feed or your Reels feed or your Explore feed looked like beforehand. And for a lot of you guys, it's not going to be specific to your niche because you've been interacting with so many other things and it's actually been hurting you on Instagram and ultimately not allowing you to grow. Another thing that you guys should do, and every single one of you should be doing this, you should be reposting other people's content that you find under those hashtags or even the top creators' content, giving them credit and using the video to your advantage. You guys need to start implementing this on Instagram. You need to realize, in Instagram 1.0, the biggest pages were either celebrities, yes, we know, Kylie Jenner, whatever, or meme pages. Meme pages grew so quickly because they were so relatable and they were literally just curating the best content for a niche. Every single one of you, whether you're a business, whether you're a personal page, whether you're just somebody that wants to get a little bit of clout on Instagram, you guys all need to be taking this into consideration and using this to your advantage. One company that I work with, Baseball Lifestyle 101, has done this perfectly. They take the top baseball posts on Instagram, on TikTok, on YouTube, everywhere, all over the internet, and have combined them into an Instagram page that has made them grow incredibly quickly. And best of all, they built a multi-million dollar business on the back of other people's content. Now, no, I'm not saying that they don't create their own content or that they steal other people's content. That's not what they're doing. They're simply curating the best content for that specific niche on Instagram. And they've been able to sell a ton of products for it, sell product placements for it. And they're taking advantage of this. And ultimately what it came down to was one, them creating great content about baseball, and two, them sourcing the best content about baseball and bringing that to light. A lot of times they'll repost somebody's video. The video originally might've gotten 10,000, 20,000, 30,000 views. They repost it, that video gets 300,000 views. Now, one, that creator gets a ton more clout because Baseball Lifestyle reposted them. And then secondly, Baseball Lifestyle is then able to take advantage of not having to create that piece of content. Now, I know I alluded to this earlier on in the video, but you guys need to make sure that right now in Instagram 2.0, this new organic reach that's on Instagram, because trust me, just like the first wave, it's not going to last forever. You need to be 100% focused on Reels. Unless you're a business, you should only be posting Reels. Don't even bother posting photos. Don't bother posting IGTV. Don't bother posting regular videos. You need to be 100% bought in, 100% focused on Reels. You need to understand Reels can show up under hashtags, the Explore page, your actual feed, the Reels feed. They have so many different placements that they can show up. That's why there's so much organic reach and not enough Instagram creators are creating Reels. That's literally why they're paying creators to post Reels. Do you think they would be doing this if enough people were creating Reels? No, they wouldn't. And that's why they're paying so many creators to post Reels. So please make sure you're producing more Reels content. You guys need to be paying attention to this. You need to be paying attention to the trends that are going on under those Reels. And once you find something that works, keep doing it. This could be a sound. This could be a video format. This could be a length. This could be the way that you write your descriptions. You need to make sure that once you find something, you continue to do it. Instagram Reels works very similar to YouTube Shorts and to TikTok, where they're simply trying to focus on the trends and surface what is trending, and you guys need to pay attention to this. You might think that a creator just chose a sound or a post type or a hashtag that they use out of the blue, but that is not the case. Creators that are taking advantage of Reels right now, the ones that you're seeing in your niche that are your competitors that are doing a great job with this, they're paying attention to all these things and now you need to focus up and start paying attention to these things too. All of that being said, if you want guaranteed growth on Instagram in 2022 or just in the next 30 days, you need to get into my mentorship program where I guarantee that I can help you grow on Instagram. In fact, I'm gonna tell you what to post, when to post, what hashtags to use to guarantee that you grow in the next 30 days. If you don't grow, I'm gonna give you your money back, zero questions asked. Now there are limited spots for this because there are so many people that wanna get into it, but I can only work with so many creators. So if you're interested, go to the link in the description. This is the same exact course that Tuvok 12 took to gain over 100,000 followers on Instagram, that Devon took to gain over 2 million followers on Instagram, that Av Moves took to gain over 1 million followers on Instagram, that Joel Magician took to gain over 500,000 followers on Instagram, and so many other creators. I'm telling you guys, the organic reach on Instagram is not going to last forever. If you wanna take advantage of this, you want brands to pay you for your your posts. You want to know what you should be posting, what hashtags to use, what time you should be posting. And again, guaranteed growth on Instagram. Nobody has ever offered this before. Nobody's ever going to be able to offer this, but I can offer this to you right now if you get into this very limited program. So please, if you're interested, sign up at the link in the description. If not, I strongly suggest you check out the next two videos I'm going to put up on the screen, because they're the videos that YouTube thinks you should watch next. Thank you so much for watching.